Hey guys, thanks a lot. And there's a whole cornucopia of opinions out here about what's the best caliber to carry for concealed carry. And thanks for tuning into my drive-by, and I'd like to get started. It's 88 degrees. It is the 4th of September today. I almost said August. 4th of September, 2015. It's about 5:11. I'm on the I-75 going southbound. So let's, without ado, get our drive-by started and have a short discussion. There is a lot of calibers made for handguns. Quite a few. You have 22, 22 short, CB 22, 22 Magnum, 22 long rifle. You have, 38, 380, 32. You have 9mm. Smith & Wesson 40, you have 10mm, you have 50-inch Express, you have 45 ACP, the list goes on and on. You have 454s, 500 Smith & Wesson, 460 Smith & Wesson. You know, there is just so many calibers that are out there for handguns and handgun calibers. It's ridiculous. And I guess the bottom line is deciding which is the best caliber you in a self-defense concealed carry scenario. First of all, let me state at the beginning of this video, any gun is better than no gun. A BB gun will be better than no gun. A pellet gun will be better than no gun. A 38, a 380. It would be better, a 22, than nothing. Okay. Why would we want to compare calipers that we're going to carry, comparing them to nothing? So, in my opinion, I've been concealed carry for over 20 years, and an NRA instructor, range safety officer, Buck Armor, and just a regular, everyday person, in my opinion, better than nothing, would be referring to 380 ACP and below. So those are guns that you would carry, bullets and calipers that you were using, if you were going to have nothing. So like you say, instead of having nothing, a 380, instead of nothing, a 22, instead of nothing, a 38, instead of nothing, a BB gun, a pellet gun, instead of carrying nothing, I would at least rather have those guns. Now, as we, you know, get that to the forefront, and now we're done with that, let's start talking, you know, fairly serious. As a general rule, a 22, a 38, a 380 ACP, I would consider backup guns. Backup guns are small guns, low capacity, low recoil, easily concealable mouse guns, small guns. You know, you're not going to go out with a small 2-inch barreled or 1-inch barreled 380 and go out and be dead on accurate at 21 feet. It just probably won't happen unless you're a superb shooter. You've been shooting for 40 years. Solid stainless steel gun, and you know, you're just not gonna. Okay? And most people that conceal carry don't shoot their guns to the extent where they would be highly accurate with these smaller caliber, shorter barreled guns. The longer the barrel normally, and the more force the bullet has, a little bit more accurate you're gonna be in the long range. I just wanted to bring that up. And I know I'll get all kind of heat from people saying 380 is a fine round, 22 is a fine. They're fine when you're comparing them to that or nothing. Yes, they are. Okay? They are. Absolutely. But I would not carry nothing. So that's a moot point. I'm not going to compare them to nothing because I would not carry nothing. I have a bigger choice. And that brings me into the next line of calipers. The next line of calipers, we're going to start with our 9mm Smith & Wesson 40, 45 ACP. Those are the three main, I would say, high reliability bullets that you'd probably want to carry. If we go through, the past, 357 was the most powerful. That's killed more people in the history of guns. Okay? 357. That definitely been more a death blow bullet than any bullet made in the history. But not everybody can handle that gun. Before, there was a hell of a lot more revolvers in circulation. So going back, 9, Smith & Wesson 40, 45 ACP. Now let's look at each round individually. There's a shitload of guns for all three calibers. You know, and tons of different configurations, 1911s, Glocks, stainless steel guns, polymer guns, double Derringers. I mean, there's just so many guns out there. It's phenomenal. The main thing we have to look at when looking at caliber is accuracy, and I would say penetrating ability. I'm not going to say stopping power, because stopping power, there's a few different variables in that, and sometimes you can actually come to the incorrect conclusion. So let's just say penetrating ability. And of course, the higher the caliber, the more power, the wider, it's going to have more penetrating ability. It just is. And yes, shooting something with a 45 ACP and hitting them in the arm will not do as much damage as if you shot them with a 22 and shot them in the heart. Yes, I know that. That's an old wife. We know that. That's common sense. So let's not go back to the people that want the sub 380, 380 and sub bullets and say, oh, shoot them in the heart. Yeah, we know that. But at the same time, shooting somebody with a 22 in the heart is a lot more or less effective than shooting somebody with a 45 in the heart. Okay? Let's just put it that way. And what we want to be able to do is to pick a caliber from those three I mentioned, 9, Smith & Wesson 40, 45 ACP, you can even select 10mm too, which would be one of probably the best rounds out of all of them. But as far as the recoil and muzzle blast and stuff, some people might not be able to handle that. But anyway, we talked before, there is porting and different type of guns and compensation, which control that and make it a heck of a lot better gun to carry. Caliper. So let's go ahead and start with the 9mm. 9mm, great bullet, slightly under 0.4 inches diameter of the 40 Smith & Wesson and 10mm. Yet it's higher than the 380. It's a good bullet. They make a lot of them in a lot of different calibers. For people who can't handle a higher caliber, don't want the inefficiency of a lower caliber, the 9mm fits, you know, it's great. If it was the only gun I could, if it was the only bullet I could realistically, accurately shoot at 21 feet, okay? And I'm saying accurate, I mean at 21 feet, putting 100% of the bullets within a 6-inch circle. That's accurate. 80% is marginal, that's like a beginner. But you want to be able to, at 21 feet, to put 100% of the bullets you're shooting within 6 inches of a bullseye. Getting bullseyes is even better. That's what you should be capable of doing with the type of bullets you pick in the 9mm and the type of gun you pick. In the 9mm, they make plus P, they make plus plus P, they make just regular ones, low recoil, and hollow points to the lot. Pick a good bullet that you're accurate with, then decide on what type of bullet. What I'm saying, pick like a 9mm, become accurate with it, and you're just standard 115 grade 4mm. jacket or something. Then pick a hollow point bullet, a defensive round, or a plus P full metal jacket bullet. That's going to penetrate better than the hollow point. So it's going to penetrate clothing better. You get an overall just better penetration from that bullet. And I wouldn't worry about over penetration because that's kind of a myth. Because there's a hell of a lot more policemen that have shot using guns that bullets that weren't over penetrating and have not stopped the person that have used over penetrating bullets and killed them behind them. So that's kind of a myth. It's kind of a little bit of overhype. So pick your bullet for stopping power and penetrating power, mainly the penetrating power. And that will make, that'll already, you'll decide if you want a full metal jacket or a hollow point. Also, your gun, pick a gun that doesn't have a lot of recoil. It's going to handle when you shoot that. It's not going to, not work the way you want it. Weigh the ability of that gun to do what you want it to do. Now let's move up to the 40 Smith & Wesson. 40 Smith & Wesson, I never was, a big person to think about that. But I really think 40 Smith & Wesson, 0.4-inch diameter bullet, same diameter as a 10mm. It's just the 10mm has a longer case, so it's more powder, so it's like a magnum. So a 10mm is a Smith & Wesson 40 magnum, is basically what it is. But it's 0.4 inches, only 0.5 under the 45 ACP. It's not a bad bullet. It handles pretty good. It's a little bit bigger. It requires a little bit more powder to put it through. So to move that, you get a little less recoil. It's a nice bullet. The magazines you came from are fairly high capacity. It's a good bullet. But again, you have to decide, is that something? And you have to mate the gun with it too. The weight of the gun, if it's ported, if it's a stainless steel gun, if it's partially stainless steel guns are really nice. You get one with a stainless steel slide, you'll get a little extra weight there. Plus, they won't wear out. Bluing wears out. But people say it flashes too much, or it's or whatever, shiny. Those are decisions you'd have to make yourself. You can get stainless steel, black matte ones too. But, mate the gun with the bullet again. Make a lot of different calipers for it. It's accurate. So let's move up to the next one, 10mm. Now, 10mm is probably one of the most powerful rounds to carry. Very accurate. I think you can get low recoil with 10mm. But on a gun like that, you're going to almost always want some kind of stainless steel gun or part stainless steel. Porting always helps those. If you can handle the gun, fine, but no. We're looking at concealed carry, so we're looking at guns that only probably have anywhere from an inch and a half to a 3-inch barrel. And that's not much to burn up all those excess gases. So that's why I'm saying porting always does help. Because the longer the barrel, the more accurate. But if you have an extreme amount of recoil, you're not going to probably put the 10mm on unless you're very, very good. Or you have a longer barrel, be able to probably put all the rounds in a 6-inch circle at 21 feet. I think it'd be hard for us to do. 9, you probably would. 40, you probably would with a matching of ammunition and gun. But 10 is a little tougher. It's more powerful than 45. That's the next one we're going to start with. So 45 ACP, big, sluggish, slow-moving, big piece of metal. 0.45 inches, just 0.5 inches under a 50 caliber. It's a big bullet. It's a big chunk of metal. They make low recoil bullets. They make fragment bullets. I mean, they make those in all the other rounds too, 9, 40, 10. It's just a big bullet, requires a little bit more gas and powder to push it through that barrel. So when you're using a gun to shoot that, that's not for everybody. Usually in a 45, same thing like a 10, I would say you're probably going to want almost 85% of the time, a solid stainless steel gun. Like an all-steel car, and porting would always help. But, you know, you may have to use a little bit bigger barrel. I mean, people have a small 1911, stainless steel 1911, would probably be perfect for a gay 45. But some of them, too, are, you know, have polymer, they have alloy, which is not going to have the weight. So ideally, probably your 40 Smith & Wesson at 9mm. 45 are great, 10mm are great, but, you know, your gun has really got to be mated to that bullet, and you have to be pretty accurate. But through careful selection of the ammunition and gun, you should be okay. But I'm talking about, you know, at least put 100 rounds through it to get used to it. And I would probably get 100 rounds of maybe the hottest full metal jacket load you could get, because you don't want to be using, like, defense ammunition, but you just want a hot load, like a plus P or plus PP, and put 100 rounds through there. Then, you know, load down to whatever your protection ammo is going to be, like maybe a 270 hollow point, just regular, and shoot it and see. Because your body will be trained, your muscle, to the higher power you'll be able to handle it. But I mean, those are just, you know, my, I guess my opinions on it. I've carried them all. I've never carried a 380, but I have carried the Smith & Wesson 38, the lightweight. And the lightweights, it's a bitch, because when you fire that, it stings your hand. It's an aluminum alloy frame, and it's just, you're not going to be real accurate with that. I mean, if they're less than 21 feet, maybe, you know, maybe seven feet to you, you might be fairly accurate, because, you know, there's recoil in that bullet flies all over the place. That's the only way I'm saying. If you have to go with something like that, go with a heavier revolver. You know, pick maybe a model 640, and I believe the 640 is like a 357. You can get them with shrouded barrels, shrouded hammers, 2-inch barrels, and you get a stainless steel one, and then use a 38. You know, maybe some low recoil bullet, but, you know, it's going to handle better because the frame is heavier, but then you're going back to a weaker bullet. You know, and it's like having a less than a 380 short barrel ammunition, because it doesn't perform as good. Then you're like marginally as high as a 380. And if anybody tells you that a 380 is just as good as like a 9, don't let them believe you. What you can do is, if you want to look at ballistics, go to www.ballistics101.com. Ballistics is BALLISTICS.com. Okay. www.ballistics101.com. And go to the drop down for ammunition, look at handgun. What I usually do is I will look at the highest handgun ammunition made for that caliber and look at the specs. Now, the highest, there was a person talking about 380 and 9mm, and the 380, the highest ammunition made for that gun, and I believe, I don't know, I can't remember exactly, the specs were like 300 or 200, like 98 foot-pounds. You've got the Buffalo Bore ammunition, plus P, and the highest for 9mm for plus P was 500 foot-pounds. So you're looking at less than 300 versus 500 foot-pounds in a protection gun. So that's what I'll usually look at. What is the highest foot-pound energy that a manufacturer makes for that bullet? And that's a good way to decide, too. So if somebody says 380, you say, okay, show me ballistics. Well, when you go on that page, they're experts, they have everything. You look for that 380. Look at what the least powerful bullet is. Look for what the most powerful bullet is. Then go to the 9mm. What is the least most powerful? What is the most powerful? And that's how you can decide. If you look at a 380 and it says the maximum power you can get out of that bullet, plus P loaded to the tilts, is maybe 286 foot-pounds. Then you go to another bullet, a 9mm, and it says, well, you can get 500 foot-pounds. What bullet would you want? It's pretty much common sense. If you shot them both at a target, which do you think would penetrate better? if they had ideal hit points. A lot of people miss, you know, in these conversations when they're talking about calibers, they always bring this up. This is just a common cop-out. Oh, if you don't hit him, if you hit him in the heart, a 22 will stop him. Well, yeah, guys, if you did shoot somebody in the heart, if the bullet penetrated the clothing, if they, you know, they had clothing on, like a thick winter coat, and it went through the rib, it broke the rib, and it went in far enough to penetrate the heart, yeah, they would probably die. Or bleed until they die, right? Yes, okay, now we're talking about a heart shot. But how many of you people out there are good enough at maybe 21 feet to shoot a bullet, a powerful enough bullet, to penetrate clothing, break a bone in a rib cage, and penetrate and go through the heart? Not many, guys. Not many. Probably not many snipers can do that. So when you're talking about these, it's a moot point. It means nothing, because you're looking already at a bullet that's weak, and you're comparing to not carrying anything. Now, if I have a 10 millimeter and I shoot somebody in the heart, right, or in that area, it's going to go through the clothes, it's going to break the ribs, and it's going to blow the heart apart. And that person's going to, you know, that person, elephant, or whatever you're shooting, is going to be dead. Shoot him with a 22, you probably won't even make it through the ribs. You probably could just get stuck in a bone. So when you weigh that and you look at that, you have to, you know, 100% weigh it. A lot of people fail to do this. And I know the old adage, oh, if you hit him in the brain. Well, put it this way, I would much rather have 15 rounds of 9mm and 8 rounds of 380 plus P9mm plus P380 and have to get to a gunfight. Because number one, the 380 would not be accurate to a shit bag, maybe 7 feet. That small barrel, most of them 380s only have like an inch and a half barrel. How the hell are you going to be in? The sights probably suck on them too. You know, at least, you know, 9mm would have a little bit bigger barrel. It's a little heavier. It's got a little bit more weight to it. And there is some good bullets you can pick out there. And then when you move up, of course, 40 Smith & Wesson, bigger bullet. You know, bigger bullet, bigger hole. Just remember that. And I realize everybody's going to be saying it's target acquisition. Yes, it is. But not many people that you think have the good enough target acquisition. Bottom line, with any gun that you're shooting, you want to be able to at 21 feet put all of your shots within a 6-inch circle. If you can do that, you can pretty much 95% guarantee you will hit what you're shooting. Not stop it, but you'll hit it. If you're accurate enough to put them all in bullseyes, more power to you. That doesn't mean you're going to possibly stop the target, but you'll have a better accuracy when you do plan to hit what you're shooting at, you'll probably hit it. But weighing that really means a lot, and that's the whole thing when picking calibers. But I hate, there's a lot of people just giving out and out wrong information out there. A lot of people, what it is, they do gun reviews, and they're gun reviewing maybe a 380 they got, then they do a 500 the next day. But take for a grain of salt with your gun reviews. Unless the guy is telling you in the gun review about the bullet and about the ballistics. I do a lot of gun reviews. I do gun reviews of Smith & Wesson 500. That doesn't mean, that blows somebody apart, blow an elk apart. That doesn't mean that's the best gun you could carry. Because if you shot that gun, chances of hitting it what you wanted, even at 7 feet, would be probably hard. You know, so you have to think about that. Weigh that. Because the people doing the gun reviews are sometimes just doing gun reviews of products they have, they bought, they like. Not as far as a gun that would be good to carry. But like I say, ideally, 380 and below, those calibers are backup guns, and they're better than nothing. But if I go out and I'm going to carry concealed carry, I don't want to be armed with something better than nothing. Okay? I want to have something better than something. So I would put it this way. Let's say somebody says, well, you get a 380, that's better than nothing. It's a pocket pistol. If you're accurate, you know, you're gonna shoot him in the heart or in the brain, right? Okay, so you have a better than nothing gun. Now, what's better than a better than a nothing gun? A 9mm, a Smith & Wesson 40, a 10mm, a 45, 454, 500 Smith & Wesson. Those are better than nothing guns. And we want to have better than nothing guns on us because we want to be accurate and we want to be able to stop the threat. But I hope, you know, people who are talking about better than nothing guns, I'm not condemning them. I'm saying those are just guns that are better than nothing. And better than nothing guns usually are backup guns. A backup gun in your glove compartment, in your dresser drawer, in the office at work. You know, it's something that's better than nothing. It's not a main concealed carry gun. It's not a home defense main gun. Just look at these pocket pistols they talk about, and you know, look at the barrels on them, look how big they are, and you have to because you're concealed carry. So concealed carry gun is going to be smaller. Sure, if you have a Vol Quartz and 22 caliber $3,000 target pistol, yeah, you could probably go out to 100 yards, but that's not in the real world. You're not going to walk around with a 18-inch gun in your pocket. So just weigh them intelligently. Some guns have a place for YouTube videos and talent show, scene show, you know. Yeah. Some guns have a place for concealed carry to protect your life. And I would never give advice for somebody to use anything less than a 9mm. And 9mm, you know, it's kind of small too, but it's not bad. A lot of police officers now are using 40 Smith & Wesson, which is kind of nice because it's a little bit bigger bullet. You know, your capacity on most of your guns are pretty good, and it's an effective round. You have hot loads, cold loads, right? And then, of course, you could go with 10mm. So, and there's 45. 45, like I say, is a little bit bigger bullet, and you really have to be particular to what gun you're going to be using when you use the 45. And we'll, later on, have another video, and I'll get into what type of frame for concealed carry, you know, polymer or stainless or carbon steel or stainless steel or alloy or aluminum or tungsten or vanadium. Just a lot of different types out. And I'll get into that and have a discussion. It might make it a little bit more intelligent for you guys. But that's today's drive-by. I hope everybody's going good. I'm getting off my exit here. And then I got another 40, 50 miles to go. So I hope everybody's doing great. And I look forward to everybody viewing my videos and commenting. And everybody, God bless you. Good.